Christmas. I know the weather's probably going to be a little bad, but that's all right. We might get some snow for Christmas, and that'd be good, according to Janet. But anyway, we're glad to hear you're here tonight. We appreciate the opportunity, and I know you're going to enjoy all the songs and the different things they have planned, and also get to eat here a little bit. We haven't done that all year, have we?
No.
We do appreciate the opportunity to get together and to celebrate the birth of our Savior and how good the Lord is to us. And not only do we celebrate His birth, but we celebrate He is a risen Savior, and we're so thankful for that. We're glad you're here. We want to go to the Lord in prayer and ask His blessing on your service tonight. And we do pray that everybody has a good Christmas. We may not be able to get together with our families like we have in days gone by, but certainly we do hope that everybody can be able to stay safe and be healthy. That's the main thing. So at this time, we'll bow your heads. We'll have a word of prayer. Father, we thank you for the day. Thank you, Lord, for being mindful of us, and Lord, just the opportunity to be able to gather here tonight in this Wednesday night service, and Lord, to celebrate your birth and sing songs of praise unto you tonight. Lift up our hands and give you praise and honor and glory. I know you're worthy of all. We ask your blessings on all these that are sick and suffering around about us. Lord, we know this is a time of the year that we usually get together with our families and our loved ones, and so many are not going to be able to do that. But Lord, may we still recognize this time of the year what this season is all about, and certainly it's about you tonight, and we thank you for it. We just ask you to bless souls, Father, for death has come and taken loved ones. I pray for the comfort of your presence. I pray, Lord, that through this season of the year, that hearts will be touched, and there will be folks come to know you as their Lord and Savior. We do pray. I ask you to bless each one tonight that has a part. You bless each helper, and we'll give you praise, honor, and glory for it all. For it's in Christ's name. Amen.
You'll turn to page 346 in your hymnal. We're going to sing the first and last verse, A Beautiful Charvet.
Thank you.
heard and turning your hymnal to 566, Silent Night. First and last.
Thank you. everybody's got a candle, and when we sing this song, we're gonna go all the way around the church and everybody lighting their candle, turning it on. Joel will start first with his, then I'll light mine, then you turn on yours, y'all turn on yours, and then we'll start here with Brenda, that row will turn on, go to Ken, Brenda, they'll turn on, and we'll go side to side all the way back through, and we all get our candle, I'll turn it on, okay?
So this particular song is not maybe what we think of as a traditional Christmas song. The name of it's Reached the World. And sometimes we leave Jesus at the manger, but we need to remember why he came to this earth. And I'll just, since I'm nervous, I won't be able to quote it, but John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, that have ever life, or everlasting life. And then in Matthew 28:19. And this is what this particular song is focusing about. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And this song talks about how we need to reach out to the world, and every person that becomes a part of our, that accepts Christ and becomes part of the family, that's another person that can help us. So that's the real reason that we're here tonight.
Thanks.